Computer-aided design is using a computer to help create what you have visualized should exist. It can be a part for a machine, it can be an object, really anything you can imagine at this point. CAD is the basis for all of the design work that's being done out there now. Whether it's buildings and architecture, whether it's landscaping, whether it's machining, all of the parts, everything we use around us was designed probably in a CAD system at this point. And being able to create those files, use those files, change those files, update those files, is a skill that's really important in today's economy.
What I like is what you're doing in class would be basically what you'd be doing in a job if you got one in that field. Kind of start out easy and just gradually build up to more complex things, and you can kind of move at your own pace.
There's a lot of lab on site so that you have support if you run into a glitch and you need more information to get by with it.
St. Louis Community College has been involved in CAD since the beginning of these systems. We transitioned from the drafting boards where it started, and we were some of the first people in the city to actually have 3D printers and additive manufacturing. One of the great things about it is all of our adjuncts work in the field. It's an evening program, there's smaller class sizes, and you come two nights, maybe four nights a week, depending on how things stack up, and you're done in two semesters. What they can go into is everything from landscaping to machine design to building architecture kind of work. Some of the more exotic and interesting ones, we have people that are working for dentists now because of the advance of additive manufacturing or 3D printing. Most of the dental implants are now designed in 3D software and then printed.
I'm retired now, but I was in the engineering industry for over 30 years. And I found the classes at Flow Valley actually prepare you for the industry.
In almost every CAD class that we offer, we do a project that uses either multiple parts or in mechanical design. One of the classes, you have to make a part that moves. Me and a buddy did this one, which is an expanding table that starts as a small table that then grows.
Students really like seeing their things come to life. They really like taking that initial concept of this is what I want and being able to draw it and make it happen. And being able to see on the screen, oh, this is what it's going to look like, great. And then that next step, particularly with modern technology of actually 3D printing it and holding it and seeing how it moves and works, is such a cool aspect of engineering and technology in general, and CAD in specific.